And one of the most interesting of those for me is the number of writers that he pointed me at. Because Bradbury, like a lot of autodidacts, took enormous pleasure in discovering new authors, finding authors, and then telling people, look, I've discovered this amazing guy, Edgar Allan Poe, you should read him. And so I, as a kid, reading Bradbury, would also find myself going off and reading Poe, and reading Kublai Khan, and reading all these stories that Bradbury would talk about. In Fahrenheit 451, you have dozens of books and stories referred to. I don't think Ray particularly influenced me in terms of prose. I don't see any sort of similarities between ways that I write and ways that Ray wrote. Possibly it's in there somewhere, low down in the DNA, but I think the subject and the fact that he was a writer who loved taking the trappings of science fiction and fantasy and did not give a hoot about the science or anything other than the story.
He just said, we're on Mars.
Absolutely, we're
on
Mars.
Who cares how we got here?
And he did not care that Mars was not his Mars. He had created a Mars. And that I found incredibly inspiring. Also, there was a story of Ray's called Homecoming, which I read when I was probably about 7, that just became my little template. For years, I didn't even know who'd written it. I just knew there was a story that I'd read that felt somehow, for me, like coming home. And it's the story that, you know, the Addams Family, the Munsters, all of that kind of stuff spun up from, of just the idea of this one little human kid living in a family of magical, strange, dark, vampiric, and monstrous creatures, and everything is normal. And I remember recognizing that and bringing us that.
What is your best advice?